KCC TV. We're on hard water.
I like to give credit to the following information to A Beginner's Guide to Ice Fishing by Levon Palikas on cottagelife.com.
One of the great things about ice fishing, especially if you're getting into the sport for the first time, is that you don't need a lot of equipment to get started. You can find most of your gear at your local bait shop. After you get your first fishing license, your key to getting through to the ice is to be getting your auger. An auger is basically a drill. And while power augers are more efficient if you're drilling a number of holes, you really only need an inexpensive hand auger in the 6 to 8 inch range to get started. When you're choosing a rod and reel combo for ice fishing, a simple setup with a fairly stiff rod and an 8 pound fishing line will cover the bases for lake, trout, walleye, perch, and plenty of other species. A tip up is a simple trap that you set with just a sinker and a minnow. When a fish takes the bait, a flag rises to alert you. Once you've sorted out your rod, reel, and auger, other items you'll want to check off your list include ice, scooper, minnows, rod holders, a bucket, a portable barbecue, food, and drink. When it comes to picking the magic lure in the ice fishing section of your local bait shop or tackle shop, the decision might seem more complicated than a teenage relationship. Truth be told, many lures work, but these days most are designed to catch fishermen rather than fish. If I could use only one method for the rest of my fishing days, it would be live bait. And live bait is especially great for beginners, because fish naturally eat minnows. That said, if you're set on using lures, worthwhile options include tube jigs and William ice jigs. Clothing is one of the most important parts of an enjoyable ice fishing trip. And the great news is you'll probably own most of what you'll need. Regular winter gear like insulated snow pants and heavy winter parkas are a must. Good gloves and a pair of insulated waterproof boots round out the ice fisherman's most important attire on the ice. You might also want to bring some extra gloves and a scarf. Although shelters aren't a necessity when you're ice fishing, they make the trip much more enjoyable, especially if there's any bit of a breeze. There are a few different kinds of portable shelters on the market, including flip-overs, hub-style, and cabin-style. But if it's your first time out, your best option might be to rent a hut. These permanent structures come with heat and all the necessities, and they're usually placed on productive fishing water. Once you have all your gear, you're ready to hit the ice. Or are you? It's extremely important to make sure the ice is at least 4 inches thick before you go out. To find out if the ice is safe, check out at your local tackle shop or with the locals. Double check its thickness just to be safe. When you're looking for an ice fishing spot, your best bet for finding productive areas is to look for large cities of huts. A collection of other huts will be a sure sign that there are fish in the area, but don't get too close. It's important to stay a respectful distance from other huts. Now that you've picked a spot, it's time to drill your holes and set up. Remove the cover from your auger blades and be very careful. They're extremely sharp. Place the blades on the ice and add an ample amount of pressure as you start to crank the auger. If you're doing it right, the auger will make a grinding noise and will slowly start to sink into the ice until it's all the way through. After drilling all of your holes, you can set up your lines with your minnows or lures. Let them descend all the way to the bottom and then reel them up 2 feet. This will place you in prime fish habitat and give you an excellent chance at a catch. The most important thing to remember about ice fishing is that it's not all about catching fish. It's about getting out and enjoying the great outdoors with friends and family, sharing laughs and good times on the ice, and experiencing moments you'll never forget.
Nice get out today, huh, guys?
Very nice.
Beautiful. A little breezy.
Yeah.
We're gonna see if we can get Mo nice big old walleye, huh, Mo? Uh-huh. Bring the lake walleye through the ice. See, looks like we got about
I wonder if I fit down here. I wonder if I just fall or I just go.
Well, 18 inches wise, pretty good.
I think I go right through.
So how do you go about catching a fish in the ice, Josh?
Well, step one, we got to we just have some dip line set up here with slip bobbers, with some bobbers and jigs and minnows, and Chase will lead you on the rest. So, Mo, you're from Florida, right?
Yeah.
You catch, do you ever fish down there?
I don't fish, but my granddaddy fish.
Really? Who do your granddad fish for?
Catfish and bass.
Really?
Yeah.
Big catfish down there, isn't
it? Huge catfish.
What's the biggest one you ever caught? Like, how does he fish for him?
Instead of using, I don't know what the fish call. They be about this big though, because some of the catfish be real huge. Uh-huh. So the fish is about that big that he got to put on the hook. And he told me to put it on one time, but I dropped it in the water because it kept.
Oh. We just had a nice little bite over there. What is it, Josh?
Small perch.
Oh. Yeah. It's a decent little perch. If you wanted, you could eat them.
First fish of the day.
Been here for about half hour and slow, just getting things set up. And Darius saw the bobber went down, but we got one, so we're on the board.
So, Mo, what do you think of this?
You know it's the insane part? I really want to cut his head off.
You want to? The fish?
I ain't never seen nothing like that, so I want to cut his head off. New experience.
And then if you look in his mouth, that little bubble right there, if you reel him up, like, too fast or, like, faster, that bubble will bubble up. Like, sometimes it'll get way bigger.
Oh.
Yeah.
All right. Let me keep up bait. All right, back in the pond.
He's still alive. In the pond.
Okay. So I'm going to tell you about this story, right?
Yeah.
Y'all listening?
Yeah, listen to this story.
KC? me and my granddaddy went fishing. We call it Taylor Creek because it's alligators stay there, fish. What else be there? Something else, but we went fishing for catfish. And he reeled one up, and instead of using the line popped. So he grabbed it with his hand, started pulling it up, and the catfish caught him.
Latched onto his hand?
Yeah. I was so glad he carried around a little pocket knife, so he was able to, like, whip it out with the other hand and, like, cut it.
Oh.
That was the only way. Otherwise, his hand would have to get cut off.
Right here.
That's your jig in the middle on it. And so when you drop it down to the bottom, you know, just drop it down to the bottom. Maybe you reel it up a few inches or feet off the bottom. Then you're going to set your bobber stopper right there. So when another mark comes in, like that line there, then you'll know it's a fish, so you'll have to maybe keep an eye on it and reel up to it or something.
Hey guys, my toes aren't cold anymore.
Looks good.
Took them long enough to warm up.
Yeah.
Your boots help at all?
They don't. Not at the toes, they don't. It's kind of just rubber, not a lot of comforter in there.
Well, what's the point of the boots if they don't keep your toes warm?
Well, they don't let any snow inside, so it's just about it. Anybody believe in Sasquatch here?
Yep.
Josh, have you ever seen Sasquatch?
No, I haven't.
I've seen them. Out in the woods.
Where did you see them at, Joe?
At the park, man. I swear. The one in the sewers.
The park by your house?
Yep.
I've seen a ghost there one time.
You go into the woods a little bit, there's an entrance to the sewers. I saw a Sasquatch. He was growling. Had a little fish in his mouth. Yep.
You sure it wasn't a bear?
No, it was Sasquatch. Probably for
Logan.
Sure.
It's probably Logan Rasmussen.
Maybe.
I'm gonna go looking for Sasquatch. I've seen him before in the sewers. I think I'll get a good sighting today. I've been putting out some food. A little bit of goldfish, a little bit of bacon bits, you know, even some maple syrup, a little bit of salt.
basic Sasquatch foods. I'm gonna find Sasquatch today. Scientific name is Saskatchewan. Folk name is Bigfoot. Oh, look at these anomaly size footprints.
How long have you been tracking Sasquatch?
Ever since I lost hope in humanity.
Oh, how long ago was that?
I don't want to talk about it. Go find Sasquatch, though.
Gonna? I've lost. I don't know where he went. He's gone. I don't.
Did you vote, Mo? You didn't vote. Why not?
I don't like eating.
Oh, wait. Did you get registered in Florida, that one?
I don't vote yet.
Yeah. Anyone from outside of Minnesota can vote in Minnesota. We're like the only state where you don't have to.
Really?
I think so, right?
No, you have to register in your state. Because Peter had
definitely
to register.
Definitely not Trump.
Yeah, but in...
I didn't.
Why not?
Didn't? Really? Really?
Really? Yeah, really, why? I'm actually curious.
He's an idiot.
He's an idiot. Yeah.
Yeah.
Why?
Well, give more detail into that.
Yeah. Are you recording right now?
We are.
I'm ready for this. I want to. I'm a big tip here. You just got to make sure you're moving the rod tip a lot, giving your wiggle worm or.
How's that work there?
Here, zoom in on the tip here. It's called the sexy wiggle.
Nice.
Just like this.
Just like that.
Got that.
Get the fish biting.
Yep.
What's the best fish for eating, Chase?
What do you think, Josh? I'd say crappie.
I like crappie.
Crappie's the best, definitely. It's pretty close to walleye, but...
A little bit sweeter.
Yeah.
It's got a sweeter taste to it.
Got a nice sweet taste?
Yeah.
How do you season it?
I take flour and I put my seasoning salt, all my seasonings in the flour, and I dunk it in the flour, and then I do an egg wash, so I just beat eggs up and put some milk in there.
Nice.
And then I do that, and then I eat, probably, my favorite is probably just like cornflake crumbs.
Cornflake crumbs?
Yeah.
Nice.
Like Dorito crumbs?
There, Dorito crumbs, saltines, and you just deep fry them. Pretty tasty.
Or you just go traditional.
What?
You have a deep fryer then?
Just use it on like the stove. Like a cast iron pan.
How about you, Chase? What's your favorite way to cook them?
Same one.
I've actually never had fish. What does it taste like?
I don't know how to describe what it... What does a fish taste like for you, Josh?
You're a fish stick?
Yeah, fishy.
I've never had fish sticks. I've only had salmon before.
Do you like fish sticks?
I've never had them.
You never had fish sticks?
Nope.
School lunch?
Nope. I always had cold lunch as a kid.
No fish sticks. Chase, do you like fish sticks?
Yeah, I love fish sticks.
You must be a gay fish.
Gay!
I get it.
You still got that. I get it.
Well, everyone. What's your guys' favorite fast food? Joey, what's your favorite fast food?
McDonald's.
McDonald's?
You know what? Yep.
Why's that?
Because I'm loving it, that's why.
I get it.
Yeah, I like it.
Mo, what's your favorite fast food?
It's between Chick-fil-A and Steak and Shake. Y'all ever heard of Steak and Shake?
I've been to one before in St. Louis.
Oh my God, it is so good.
It's pretty good.
The shake's just the bomb.
Okay, Chase, how about you?
I'm gonna go with Hardee's.
Hardee's?
Quality food.
Oh, yeah.
Good taste, fast service.
$4 real deal?
Real deal.
Casey?
McDonald's.
Yeah. Darius?
We all know that's gonna be Hardee's.
Yeah.
Although you work at Hardee's? Sometimes when you work somewhere, you begin to hate the
Nope,
food.
He loved it. Hardee's is a great place. You know,
you talk to a lot of people who work at McDonald's.
They hate it.
Not gonna lie, my favorite food would
I eat at Hardee's
probably have to be, I love Chipotle. Chipotle's my life.
Hey guys, I think I see one on the graph.
Yeah,
I got one, guys. Chase, what do I do?
Here,
reel
early? Dude, wait, reel up until you feel heavy. Oh, here you go. I think you got them on there. Oh, it's tiny. It's really small.
Shoot. Oh, look at that.
Oh, there it is. The little perch. Joey got his first fish. How do you feel?
Feel pretty good.
Are you doing it? Oh, no, that's his eyes. You want
to hold me up by the eyes.
Here. It's in his mouth a little bit full.
Well,
catch of a day.
Two perch today. One from a dead stick, one from a jigging rod.
What's this red stuff? What's that?
Fins? Those are his fins, yeah. They're orange.
Oh, he's got some fight in them.
Crap. Where'd you put that?
Some pliers?
I can't get a hold of those hooks. You can hold them in his mouth.
Smile for the camera.
Just hold it like this.
Yeah.
Through its mouth.
Through its mouth?
Yep. And go like that. Just so it's sideways a little bit. There you go.
Joey got his first fish. He likes his ever. First fish 3 days ever. How does it feel?
It's pretty good.
What did you do when you saw him? Was he biting the rod pretty good and then you set the hook?
It was dipping a little bit. Saw it on the graph. I was like, oh.
Okay, well, let's let her go and see if we can get a walleye now.
Yeah.
He is.
Blurry as what?
He wanted to.
Hello? I'm on the lake. I don't know.
What are you talking about, Willis?
I gotta be back by 12. I'm gonna be back in town to give them, so. Yeah. Yeah. If he's crabby, you should be able to be, you'll be okay. Yeah, we got one. Sounds good, bye. He's coming up. There he just got back down.
Do I gotta use some snap?
Here, get ready, Mo.
Is it recording still?
Yeah, it's recording.
You bump it in his face.
It smells like Wendy's.
It smells like Wendy's.
I smelled Wendy's yesterday coming from my game. But I smell it in here. It smells like chicken nuggets.
That's chicken me. Nuggets? I didn't even know Wendy's
and
had
the bag down there.
Give me that bag right there.
Does it smell a little bit like that?
Yes. Oh my god. It smells so good.
Almonds. Almonds are nuggets.
They're hot. They're wasabi.
They're wasabi.
Never mind.
They got a good bite to
them. Nice burn.
Do we still have a rod over in that hole or no?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
We got no election yet. Have anybody ever slipped in one of them holes?
Any what?
Have anybody ever slipped in one of them holes?
Probably.
Is she recording?
Probably. That's alright. We can just
fix it out.
Where did that... Oh, where'd you find that?
Under the...
Have you been to Braley Gilbert?
No.
Shotgun Mike. Tick tock, I'm on the clock, and the dollar's down. It's 9 to 5 of my life away. Is that bobber going down, Joey?
Going down.
She said she would skip school tomorrow and go over to Lake of the Woods. I'm so down for that. It's payday.
It's payday.
So what do we got here, Chase?
I don't know. We're hooked up.
It's a little wide. Oh, shit. Lost him down the hole. Walk us through that
and
one.
And that's part of the really... You got to be really careful when you're pulling him up. You can't... I was just going to try to lift him out of the hole with my rod.
Were you not ready for that one?
I wasn't, actually. Josh didn't get it on film, but the rod was just bouncing hard, and so I reached over, snagged it, and then he grabbed the camera, and you guys saw the rest.
Couldn't get him through the hole. Little guy, though.
Yep. We'll see what we can do the rest of the time.
You might as well bring him up and catch him.
Here we are. Josh, what are you hooked up with, bud?
I can't tell.
Just a little like eye?
Little eye.
Ooh.
Just a little guy.
Any words?
You know, pretty slow day, slow night. Got one here, I have to let him go, but
just a little guy, don't fall there, buddy.
Beautiful little fish there. Too bad that last one got off the hook, huh?
Give it a few more years.
Oh!